Hi, pipe smokers. This is Paul the Pipe Guy, live from the outskirts of Rochester, New York. Yeah, in upstate New York, in the United States of America. And what we're going to do is we're going to review a pipe that I bought quite some time ago. It is a handmade pipe that is near and dear to me. I am lucky enough to own two of them. And the maker is Brian Kalnitz. He's been a pipe maker for, I don't know, 40 or 50 years. And this pipe that we have for your review, tonight, it's actually made of 200-year-old briar. There's no factory fills in that, nothing. Sorry if the lighting isn't so good. No, I'm not sorry. It is what it is. That is 200-year-old briar. And the pipe maker actually lives not too far from me, in upstate New York. And he uses no bowl numbers. It just says on the bottom, and you can't see that, it just says B. Kalnitz. Handmade, all right? So, in review of this pipe, all right? I was lucky enough to get this. I paid up for it, all right? So, the pipe smoker will love this. Yeah. So, as far as dimensions, we have the overall front to back dimension on here would be 6.206 inches. And the bowl width on the outside, and like I said, this one is a octagon style, not a hexagon. So the bowl width at the top would be 1.31 inches. Okay, the inner diameter of the bowl, okay, that is let's hold it this way. Bear with me. The inner diameter of the bowl is 0.678 inches, and the depth of the bowl, the depth of the bowl would be 1.68 inches deep. So that makes it a a pretty nice pipe. And like I said, no factory fills. Oh my gosh, look at that gorgeous briar. And it's not a 10 millimeter or a 9 millimeter. That's what it is, all right? That's what it is. The draw on the pipe. You hear that little whistle? That means that the pipe maker did not take the inside of the stem and, like, you get it, right? You're supposed to take the inside of the stem and bevel it a little bit so you don't get that whistle. Unfortunately, this pipe maker didn't do that. So you get that whistle. But as far, these are all handmade from scratch. 200-year-old briar. Look at that. It's a hexagon pipe. Yeah. And let me tell you, I've smoked this before and it smokes unbelievable. I don't like that whistle. I'm going to fix the whistle myself. We're going to pause the video. We're going to load it up. Yeah. And I'm going to fix the whistle myself. Yeah. Why didn't the pipe maker do that? Charges like $300 for these pipes. They shouldn't whistle that while they work. Sorry, Brian, but, you know, I'll fix it. I'll be right back. All right, Mr. Kalnitz, I'm not a pipe maker. Ah, yeah, Mr. Kalnitz, I'm not a pipe maker, but I did. There's still a little bit of a whistle. Let's do a full draw. Not as bad as it was. But what that creates inside the stem, if it's not beveled on the inside, that creates a whistle. And I don't know. I'm not a pipe maker. I should just shut up. But if I take a medium draw off of it, there's no more whistle. If I take a hard draw off of it, there's a slight bit of whistle, but I'm not going to work on this pipe anymore tonight. Yeah. So, now we're going to smoke it. Yeah. We'll be right back. All right. This is Paul the Pipe Guy back. Yeah. Live from upstate New York. Yeah. And we got this beautiful Brian Kalnitz pipe we're going to do. Yeah, we're going to do it out. But first, you must clear the palate. All right, anyway, so probably get a hit for that. Yeah, anyways, you know what that is. So what we have in our Brian Kalnitz pipe, and I did fix the whistle. Brian, I'm not even a pipe maker. Well, there's a little whistle. Anyway, so what we have in this for tonight is we have some, oh yeah, one of my favorites, Officers Club. Yeah, let me read you about this. All right. This is a pipe review, but I want to talk about the tobacco. I'm smoking in it, and I got this from East India Trading Company on 7 of 2021. Officers Club combines Virginia's, Burley's, Black Cavendish with rum. Yeah. Who doesn't like rum? All right. Gentle spices and creamy vanilla that will make you think of a decadent dessert. Officers Club will be truly satisfying after a hearty evening meal, which I haven't even had my meal yet, but it doesn't matter because I wanted to make this video for my mates and made it. Let's start something on fire. Yeah, here we go. Mm. This brand, Kalnitz pipe, made in Buffalo, New York, not far from me, within 60 miles. Other than the whistle, which I fixed, this is superb, and what a great freaking midnight snack, some officers club, yeah. I only got like 10 tins of that. You know, you gotta stock up on stuff, eh? Oh, what a smooth smoking pipe. And like I said, 200-year-old briar on there. But the stem, right, the stummel needed some reaming out, you know, and so it didn't whistle. And by the way, I'm going to take a break from that, and I want you all to see. Come here, Kelly. This is how big Kelly the Killer Calico Cat has gotten now. Look at her. Oh my gosh, she's beautiful. Yeah. Say hi, Kelly. Used to always love to be in the videos. And we started when I got Kelly, she was only about 7 inches long. And now she's looking to escape, you know. She's got a little, I don't know. Say hi, Kelly. She's all done. All right, she doesn't want to be in the video anymore. Oh my gosh, let's turn that freaking Stones tune back on, you know? Cheers. I fixed the whistle on this. I can't believe it. Kelly's happy. I'm happy. Oh, gosh. If you get the chance to get a brand Kalnitz pipe, do it, you know. I own two of them, and the other one doesn't have a whistle. This one did, but I fixed it, and I can fix your pipe too. And I ain't clenching this, Brad. Oh, Lord. This officer's club is so good. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm Paul the Pipe Guy. Yeah, live from the outskirts of Rochester, New York. Yeah, subscribe to my channel. Tell your friends about me. We're up to, 617. Which means that we're going to have a GAW, a giveaway. Wanted to make sure I was at a solid over 600, but subscribe to my channel, tell your friends about it, and we do all kinds of crazy stuff on this channel, you know. It's not all about pipe smoking, although I love it. It's about music, too, and it's about life. Anyways, Paul the Pipe Guy, live from the outskirts of Rochester, New York. Still alive, over and out. Yeah, hit that bell. So you get, you know, look, you guys aren't stupid, all right? If you want to see my videos, just subscribe and, you know, hit the reminder bell. I come out with all kinds of crazy stuff. I can't believe I got rid of that whistle. Isn't that so great? Over and out.